Hey, today me, Nicolas Riveras, together with Victoria Rodriguez and Cristina Bitzgal, will present the topic of our project, and we want to use this time to tell you a little bit about how sublimation, soil erosion, and soil aggregation are driven and impacted by microorganisms biocrossing vegetation. When we say soil, we speak about the thin layer of the Earth's surface where atmosphere, hydrosphere, lithosphere, and biosphere interact. And why should soil be considered within the scope of Earth shape? Many processes occur here that are central in regulating the shaping of Earth's surface. Due to complex interactions between soil minerals and organic compounds, regulated by the presence of biota, such as vegetation and microorganisms, soil structure is created, and this is central because soil structure and aggregation of soils are important for a very high range of aspects. A well-structured soil can stand water and wind erosion. They are more resilient against compaction, have an increase in water retention capacity, and play an important role in the storage and stabilization of soil carbon. Even in very poorly developed soils, where water and nutrient availability is scarce, the life of resilient microbial communities can be sustained, and these communities can form a so-called biological soil crust or biocrust. These communities can gradually improve the condition of the undeveloped soil, for example, by dissolving and fixing nutrients or creating microclimatic conditions, and ultimately allowing more demanding species, such as higher plants, to enter the system. This can, in a long term, result in more stable, resilient, and deep soils, harboring higher contents of nutrients. In this context, the coastal Cordillera of Chile provides a unique climatic as well as ecological gradient that includes soils at different stages of development, but still with a common parent material. This allows us to disregard this factor as part of soil formation, and in test, only focusing on the factors of our research interest, in our case, biota. But now, Cristina can tell you a little bit more about that.
So, in this project, our main focus is to figure out how vascular plants, biocrusts, and microorganisms contribute to shaping soil surfaces, soil aggregation, and the stabilization and allocation of organic matter. We will approach this topic in three main simulation experiments, each focused on chemical, physical, and biological processes, and they are called SoilSim, EroSim, and ClimSim. In essence, since soil formation is a result of combined and interrelated effects of chemical, physical, and biological processes, our project is divided into three sub-projects, where me, Cristina, will focus on exploring the impact of vascular plants and biological soil crusts on soil aggregation and carbon stabilization. Nicolas will be working with connecting the effect of biocrusts and soil development with erosion processes. And Victoria will be investigating the effect of microbial communities on soil stabilization and soil development. I will now tell you a bit about two experiments within my PhD project, part of the SoilSim project, with the name Soil Structure Development and Organic Matter Allocation driven by vascular plants and biological soil crusts along a climate gradient. So what I, together with my research team at the Technical University in Munich, would like to find out is how interactions between microorganisms, biocrusts, and vascular plants drive the formation of soil aggregates, and how they influence the distribution and the stabilization of soil organic matter. We have approached this topic with two experiments. In the first, we have incubated intact soil cores, or soil monoliths, with soils at different stages of development. And in the second one, we look into root effects of living in dead plants and roots in top and subsoils. For the soil monolith experiment, we collected 30 monoliths from Santa Gracia, La Campana, and Naulbuta. These monoliths were incubated for 4 months in a climate chamber where parameters such as light intensity, photoperiod, humidity, temperature, and CO2 levels were set to resemble the climate of Naulbuta. In this experiment, we only worked with inherent seed banks in the cores, meaning that the plants and biocrusts emerging germinated spontaneously. And now that the incubation is finished, we have divided all cores into 5 depth increments and will in the next step do analysis such as aggregate fractionation to look into the vertical gradient of aggregate stability and allocation of carbon. We would like to measure plant and root biomass and mycorrhiza to track plant-microbe interactions, and extract P-leaf A and DNA to look into the abundance, structure and functionality of microbial communities. In our second experiment, we are focusing on the influence of living and dead roots on biologically induced soil aggregation within the rhizosphere, and we are comparing these effects between top and subsoil from Santa Gracia. In the first part of the experiment, the samples were incubated with Helenium aromaticum growing, a species native to the area. After 4 months, the first half of the samples were collected, representing the living plant root samples. In the second part, the remaining samples were kept in complete darkness for another 4 months, during which the plants died and roots started to decompose. These samples represent dead plant root samples. We have started with some analysis, for example, phospholipid fatty acid analysis, and the first measurements have shown interesting patterns. Here we could observe a shift in the microbial community structure between living and dead plant root samples. We can see a decrease in fungi to bacteria ratio between the treatments, as well as a significant decrease in the abundance of fungal biomarkers after plant death, whereas the abundance of bacteria remains fairly stable. These changes in the soil microbiome are quite interesting, and we look forward to being able to share a more complete story with you soon.
Hey again, Nico here. Our second experiment are surface shaping by soil erosion along the climate gradient, or just erosion, was proposed to identify how and to what extent biota stabilize the soil against water erosivity. Connecting the biological activity with water-induced erosion processes and its effects on the geomorphology. For this purpose, we will collect undisturbed soil monoliths in 4 national parks distributed along 1,500 km of the coastal range in Chile, covering 4 climatic conditions. Then, we will apply a standardized precipitation of 45 mm per hour for half an hour from a height of 4 meters, locating the samples under this with a small inclination to avoid ponding. Then, we will collect the surface runoff and the percolated water of the samples to analyze how carbon and the other components are moved by the action of erosion, and how soil aggregates are destabilized by this process. The sampling phase of this experiment has not yet finished. To date, there is only a base characterization of the soils of the study sites.
I'm Victoria, and as a part of my PhD, I will talk about the role of microbial communities as drivers of soil development and stabilization under changing climatic conditions, whose experiment is known as ClimSim. The objective of this project is to understand the structure and function of microbial communities and their impact on the development and stabilization of initial soil environment. In this context, Pan de Azúcar and Santa Gracia will be used as examples of initial soils. With both sites, a manipulation experiment of the transformation of initial soils to a resistant soil ecosystem will be developed, using the climatic conditions of Nahuel Buda. The samples will be evaluated by themselves and in conjunction with biocrust and pioneer plants, representing different states of soil development. In addition, a sterile control without microorganisms will be used. The soil physico-chemical parameters and the results of molecular characterization of samples before and afterwards the manipulation will be analyzed. Regarding the advances, DNA from time zero has been extracted and qPCR was done. The graphs show the abundance of soil bacteria. The axis X indicates the gene copy number per gram of soil, and the axis Y, the 3 different horizons. The results indicate that the greatest abundance of bacteria is found on the horizon A, at all sites, and Nahuel Buda has the highest abundance, followed by La Campana, Santa Gracia, and finally Pan de Azúcar. In the horizon B, Nahuel Buda, La Campana, and Santa Gracia have a similar abundance and higher than Pan de Azúcar, while in the horizon C, the abundance is lower in all sites. In addition, a pilot experiment was developed to test if the applied environmental conditions were well with initial soils. a development of plants and biograss was observed after 12 weeks, concluding that the conditions are suitable to start with the real experiment. So, where does this lead us? With this project, we wish to establish to which extent mutual interactions between microorganisms, biograss, and vascular plants drive the formation of aggregates and stable soil surface. Further, we want to identify how the biota stabilizes the soils and modifies the water movement and sediment detachment. Lastly, we hope to understand the variation of dominant microorganisms, the spatial dynamics of specific groups, and the functional diversity associated with soil formation. So, in the end, we hope to contribute to an improved understanding of the combined effect of biotic and abiotic drivers for soil development and soil stabilization at air surface.